According to SpaceX CEO Elon Musk, colonizing Mars will not be easy. Elon Musk has hinted that a crewed mission to Mars could take place in 2029. Welcome to First Class Tech, and in this video, we'll take a look at Elon Musk's update on Mars colonization 2022. Curious to know? Let's find out. Elon Musk has repeatedly expressed his strong interest in human colonization of Mars. On Monday, a tweet comparing the moon landing to a future Mars landing included a 1969 photo of the moon landing on top of an image of an envisioned Mars landing labeled 20. The tweet from Space Hub, a space and astronomy account, read, "What's your guess?" and tagged Musk. Musk responded 2 days later with 2029. Musk has long envisioned a trip to Mars. He stated in 2016 that he wished to construct a rocket capable of transporting people to Mars and supporting a permanent city on the planet. "It's something we can do in our lifetimes," he told a crowd of 100,000 people in Guadalajara, Mexico, at the International Astronautical Congress. "You could leave." However, Musk's previous predictions do not always correspond with his most recent. In 2016, he told the startup accelerator Y Combinator that landing a significant number of people on Mars was possible in about 10 years, maybe sooner, maybe 9 years. Transportation, as obvious as it may appear, is the lifeblood of any project to make Mars our second home. It literally determines whether or not Mars can be colonized. Musk intends to reduce the cost of rocket launch to $10 per kilogram of weight, which is critical to making the trip to Mars a reality. So, what does it take to achieve that level of cost effectiveness? The solution is to use reusable rockets. SpaceX emphasizes reusability over NASA's old, inefficient, single-use rockets. Not only will this be better for the environment because we won't be creating space debris, but it will also allow SpaceX rockets to become more cost and time efficient. Meanwhile, due to the ongoing conflict in Ukraine, a joint European-Russian Mars mission called ExoMars was suspended on Thursday. This rover mission, the first in a two-part series, was scheduled to launch in 2022. The two-part mission was designed to determine whether or not there was ever life on Mars. While acknowledging the impact on scientific space exploration, ESA is fully aligned with the sanctions imposed on Russia by its member states, the intergovernmental organization said in a statement. According to SpaceX CEO Elon Musk, colonizing Mars will not be easy. "It's critical to emphasize that Mars, especially at first, will not be luxurious," Musk said in a video interview with Chris Anderson, the head of TED Conferences, released Monday. "It'll be dangerous, cramped, difficult, and exhausting work." By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic. Elon Musk plans to launch at least 3 reusable Starship space shuttles per day, each with a payload of at least 100 tons. This establishes a yearly estimate of 100,000 tons of cargo transported with the assistance of 1,000 Starships. Elon Musk has also stated that every 26 months, 1,000 Starships will be able to transport 100,000 people. The Earth-Mars orbital sync lasts 26 months, indicating how long it takes for the Earth's and Mars orbit to align optimally for transportation. But why is it necessary for a Starship fleet to transport at least 100,000 people every 26 months? These numbers appear to be far too precise to be coincidental. The billionaire compared Mars recruitment efforts to a 1900s ad for an expedition to Antarctica with explorer Ernest Shackleton. The ad has since been debunked as a myth, but it sought men willing to embark on a hazardous journey with a promise of a safe return. "It's dangerous. It's cramped," says the sales pitch for going to Mars. "You might not be able to return. It's difficult and demanding work," Musk stated. Living on Mars, a planet with an average temperature of negative 80 degrees Fahrenheit, would be far more difficult than living in Antarctica, which has an average temperature of negative 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Mars' surface is rocky, with volcanoes and canyons. In addition, the planet has one-third the gravity of Earth and a thinner atmosphere that is unbreathable for humans. Insider previously reported that due to Mars's low atmospheric pressure, a human without special equipment would perish within minutes. Mars's terrain is harsh and uninhabitable, as we know it. There's not a lot of oxygen or water. And did I mention the insane dust storms? For the time being, Mars is uninhabitable, but scientists, including Elon Musk, believe that terraforming can provide humanity with a second home in space. Many months later, it was determined that terraforming Mars with current technology was simply not possible. Despite this, SpaceX has continued to experiment with new Mars terraforming concepts. The installation of glass domes on Mars' surface, for example, is one possible solution that has gained traction beyond niche groups. Glass domes are self-contained domes that provide their own water, oxygen, and food. These domes were also intended to serve as communities with leisure and work centers. Although promising, it should be noted that for the time being, the aforementioned are only rough sketches of the future. SpaceX's current focus is solely on developing safe and cost-effective interplanetary transportation. Human habitat construction projects on Mars have been prioritized lower. SpaceX, on the other hand, has confirmed that they are undeniably on the right track toward that unavoidable possibility. Humans will not be the only passengers above the starships. Cargo is also an important part of any mission, from the bare necessities to movie theaters and vitamin C, all of which are thought to necessitate additional space and money for transportation. Musk wishes to construct a full-scale city on Mars. Musk estimated in 2019 that it would take 1 million tons of cargo to build a self-sustaining city on the planet, a process that would cost anywhere from $100 billion to $10 trillion. According to Anderson, the billionaire hopes that those who colonize Mars will use the opportunity to rethink society. I think this is important for maximizing humanity's or consciousness's probable lifespan, Musk told Anderson. Human civilization could end due to external factors such as a giant meteor, supervolcanoes, extreme climate change, World War III, or any of a number of reasons. Experts believe that, as with most things related to Mars, this is unlikely to be possible with current technology. Finally, Elon Musk has admitted that we will never see Mars terraforming in our lifetime. Musk, on the other hand, has stated that human colonies on Mars and will be established within this generation, which is also his current and ultimate goal. The idea of colonizing Mars, like any other, is fraught with ethical quandaries. Given the establishment of space law and the agreement governing the activities of states on the moon and other celestial bodies, SpaceX Mars has also declared Mars to be a free planet with distinct rules and legislation from Earth. The world's richest man told Anderson that SpaceX would set a price for tickets on future rockets to Mars that would be reasonably priced for most people, citing a $100,000 hypothetical ticket price. Musk's company, SpaceX, intends to build a self-sustaining city over the next several decades. However, the billionaire told Anderson that he expects to be long dead before his dream becomes a reality. Arguments have been made that Mars is not only far away, hostile, and difficult to reach, but it also has no obvious valuable export, making it highly unprofitable. Elon Musk has also confirmed that trading mined minerals to Earth isn't profitable enough to justify the transportation cost. Musk, on the other hand, has worked hard to promote intellectual property as the primary export of Mars. Despite this, we and any investors could only hope for the best, a profitable and sustainable Martian colony. Governments and enthusiasts will have to pay for this advancement in human civilization out of pocket unless a Martian colony can generate its own value. Musk stated in 2020, they hope to build 1,000 starships in 10 years and to send 1 million people to Mars by 2050. He has also stated that the first human landing on Mars could occur in 2029. Depending on regulatory approval, SpaceX CEO Elon Musk anticipates the company's first orbital launch for the starship within a few months. Success isn't guaranteed, but excitement is, Musk says. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. Are you excited for Mars colonization? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.